substitute teacher shortly after emigrating from the island of Trinidad. And then he went on to become a member of the United States Congress, Lieutenant Governor, the first African-American Lieutenant Governor in the United States, State Senator, State Assembly Member, and of course, faculty member here at the School of Nursing. Legendary in his role, often called Godfather, Emissary, Counselor, Ambassador, etc. Thank you again very much for being here. At this point, I would like to ask the Honorable Dr. Mark Ridley-Thomas, our LA County Supervisor of the 2nd District, to come forward and share with us remarks as well.
Thank you very much, Dr. Carlisle, and to all who are assembled for this very special occasion in many respects. So you can find it as a historic occasion, another tribute to the Honorable Dymally.
I also want to thank Dr. Kenneth Orduna. Ken took on the task of fundraising. He single-handedly reached our goal in raising $60,000 for the Mervyn M. Dymally Monument. Thank you, Ken.
Thank you. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
This is a very special day. We finally brought the chairman home. You know, it's been a long journey to get here. I see so many staff members here, former staff members and friends. It's like all reunion week. But the supervisor, maximum leader, Nigel reached out to me in 2000, right after the congressman's home going in 2012. I was not that moved by it. I didn't want to do anything else. We just put the chairman to rest. But then in January, I met with him and I saw what he was doing and what he wanted to do. And I was very touched and moved by that. So he came up with an idea. Well, I tell you what, I'll do 10 unlimited editions of this monument. And I reached out to a lot of folks and 10 came through. I delivered most of them to those recipients or to those donors, they have them, with the exception. There's one I had, we've been chasing him all over the place. And today I want to present this to him. The Honorable Richard Alatorre.
Yeah.
This is, I won't have it unveiled yet until we get this done, but then you can look at it. But it's an exact replica of what we're about to see at the end.
This day was made possible by our most talented artist, Nijel Binns. Nigel conceived of the idea of making a sculpture of my husband. Nigel Binns is an internationally recognized African-American sculptor and painter in the realist tradition. His portraits and monuments are noted for their ability to capture and evoke the inner spirit of the subject. Nigel received commissions for the only one-size bronze sculpture of legendary actress Shirley Temple for Fox Studios, a life-size bronze bust of retired Urban League president John Mack for the Urban League headquarters, and a life-size bronze bust of Honorable Nate Holden for the Nate Holden Performing Arts Center in Los Angeles. Ladies and gentlemen, Nigel Binns.
I'd like to thank all my students for being here as well as the students of the university. And ladies and gentlemen, thank you for all being here this morning on this historic occasion. You know, much has been said and written about the remarkable life of the Honorable Mervyn M. Dymally. But when this statue is unveiled, know that it represents not only honors and accolades, but it's really about celebrating character and determination. I must also add that I was grateful to receive a copy of this book from you. It is Mr. Dymally's autobiography. From island immigrant to U.S. Congress. I'd like to thank Dr. David Carlisle for accepting this statue, and to Dr. Shirley Evers Manley, Mrs. Angela Minifield, Mrs. Carrie Irving, and all the members of the Charles R. Drew University staff for making it possible for this monument to have a permanent home here at the Mervyn Dymally School of Nursing. Now, as I read the list of these 10 special people who chose to donate to this project, I know that your true friendship to Mr. Dymally will always be remembered. As a bronze monument, it will be interesting for you to know that this will probably last for 1,000 years, as will the miniature bronze that you purchased to help finance this project. Now, this is my assurance to you that no further copies will be produced. Mrs. Dymally, Mr. Ken Orduna, and Dr. Carlisle to join me.